the last time we left you off, right before the Bayern game.
Yeah.
How did it feel to go on the pitch in München?
Look, it was an amazing experience. I think to be able to go to Munich and get the 3 points, it was fantastic for me personally, but for the team, it was I could see how much it meant to everyone, and I was just happy to be a part of it and to, you know, to play my part in getting the win.
And right after we won the match, everyone stormed up to you. Klopp lost his glasses, but people stormed up to you to celebrate your performance after you saved Gomez. What did it mean to you?
Look, it was amazing to be able to, you know, to play there and to get the win, and, you know, to be able to be a part of it with the boys. That was the most important thing, and, you know, I could see after the game how much it meant to everyone, and, you know, for me personally, it was just brilliant to be involved.
And all your mates in Australia stayed up?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Got up early in the morning, it's 6 a.m.
I think it was 3:30, 4:30 in the morning, so everyone got up, and no, it was good.
And you got out a message to them via, like, Gixie Byte or who? He put it up on the Melbourne board.
I'm not too sure.
They just loved it. They talked about it. And you still connect to Melbourne Victory, and you're still in touch with all the guys there.
Yeah, of course. I think, the 3 years I had at Melbourne, it was fantastic. I enjoyed every minute of it. And you know, I've still got so many friends there. And, you know, I always watch how the boys go because it's close to my heart. But, you know, it's fantastic to feel still involved with the boys back home. But, you know, now I'm here and I'm enjoying every minute of it. And, you know, I just can't wait for the next game.
So, and today, another shout out, no goal. And but you never really got the chance to prove yourself today.
Yeah.
How does it feel? Like, be on the pitch.
Yeah.
And there's no chance to prove yourself.
Look, it's good to play. And, you know, it's better when you're not doing too much because The boys in front of me were fantastic. They kept it quiet for me, and, you know, it makes my job a lot easier. So credit to the boys in front. They did a fantastic job. It's unfortunate we didn't nick a goal and, you know, finish nil all, but, you know, that's football, and, you know, a clean sheet from the defensive side of things is a good result.
And next week, you'll be meeting up with the Socceroos. Your first call-up, when we first met, you said there's no chance we're going to see that in a year or two.
Yeah.
How does it feel like Ozier calling you up?
Like I said earlier, it's a fantastic experience. I think to get recognised by your country is amazing. I'll go in there, you know, full of energy, you know, a little bit of nerves, but that's normal. And, you know, hopefully we can get a good result against the Germans. And I'm sure there'll be a bit of friendly banter between myself and Schmeller and Mats and Money.
And before that, you're going to play Schalke 2, I hear, on the training camp.
Yeah, there's a...
It's going to be your performance against the Blues again.
Yeah. I think in the training camp we'll have a game against Schalke Reserve. So being a B4B player, it's going to be special, you know, to be able to play against Schalke, and hopefully we can get a win. And I know how much it means to all the Borussia fans. So there'll be a bit of an extra edge for me personally to be able to play against them. And, you know, I'll be representing Australia, but I'll also be representing Borussia in that game.
Okay. So to finish off on a sad note, you've been in contact with Shinji at all?
No, I haven't. But word is, you know, he's all right, so that's fantastic. It's obviously very sad over there in Japan, but, you know, fingers crossed the people can pull through. It's tough times over there, but, you know, our thoughts and prayers are obviously with all the Japanese people.